Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. So as we know, we are discussing our lesson and the name of the lesson is what? Nutrition in plants. Okay, so in that already we have discussed some points. We have discussed about the different modes of plant, that is autotrophic and heterotrophic. Also we have discussed about the process of photosynthesis. Okay, so today we'll move for the next point. Today we'll discuss about which are the things which requires for the process of photosynthesis, that is nothing but what? Requirements of photosynthesis. So which things are necessary to perform the photosynthesis process? Okay, so with the help of water and minerals, carbon dioxide, chlorophyll and sunlight, with the help of all these things the photosynthesis process happens. Okay, so one by one we'll discuss all these different factors and from where the plants is getting these different factors, that we'll discuss. So let's start. So first we'll discuss about the water and minerals. Okay, so these water and minerals are get absorbed from the root of a plant with the help of the one tissues. Okay, or the with the help of the one pipe like structure, and that pipe like structure is called as what? Silent tissues. Okay, it is called as silent tissues. But the water and the minerals from the root get absorbed by the plant with the help of one process, and the name of that process is called as what? Osmosis. Okay, so see, as we know, this is the plant. So from the root the water get transported up till the leaf. So how it get transported up till the leaves? With the help of one process, and that process is called as what? Osmosis. So let's discuss what is mean by osmosis. Before the going to see the osmosis, we'll discuss about one definition. That is what? The membrane which allows only certain molecules to pass through it is called semi-permeable membrane. Okay, so the membrane or the one sheet, one layer we can say that, which allow only the certain type of the substances to go inside. Okay, means all the substances cannot enter, cannot penetrate that membrane. Only the certain substances can enter into that membrane or into that sheet, and that membrane is called as what? Semi-permeable membrane. See, semi means what? Why semi? Because it is not, there is no entry for all the substances in that membrane. Only the certain substances can get enter into that membrane, and that is the reason that membrane is called as what? Semi-permeable. Permeable means what? We can say that small, small holes are there on that membrane. With the help of that, the substances get enter. It is called as what? Semi-permeable membrane. Okay, the membrane which allow only the certain molecules to pass through it is called semi-permeable membrane. Okay, so this is about the semi-permeable membrane. Okay, but why it is necessary to understand the semi-permeable membrane? Now you can understand. See, the movement of water molecules from the region of higher concentration through a semi-permeable membrane is called osmosis. So what is mean by osmosis? Osmosis is the process in that what happened, the movement of water molecules are happened. The water molecules get run or get pass, okay, with the help of the semi-permeable membrane. With the help of the semi-permeable membrane, that process is called as what? Osmosis. But very important thing is remaining, that is what? The movement of water molecules from the region of higher concentration. Now higher concentration means what? There are the so much molecules of a water. Okay, from that so much molecules of the water, it runs to the higher concentration. Okay, means the less molecules are there, from that less molecule it moves to the higher molecules. Okay, means more concentration is there. Okay, so this one again I am going to repeat: the movement of water molecules from the region of higher concentration is from the less molecules to the higher molecules. Okay, the molecules move from the less molecules to higher molecules through a semi-permeable membrane. Here already we have discussed about the semi-permeable membrane, and that process is called as what? It is called as what? Osmosis. So with the help of the osmosis, the water and minerals get transported to the different parts of a plant. Okay, so once it get absorbed, it transported to the different parts of a plant, in the stem, in the branches or in the leaves, with the help of the pipe pipe-like structures are there, or different vessels are there, like these pipelines are there, and these pipes are nothing but the one type of the tissue, and the name of the tissue is nothing but what? Xylem. It is called as xylem. Okay, these tissues are called as xylem tissues. Okay, or these xylem tissues are act as a pipelines. Okay, with the help of that pipes, the water gets upward, and once it gets upward, it never comes down. Okay, so in this way, the water full the water and minerals get absorbed or get from the roots. Okay, for the process of photosynthesis with the help of the osmosis process. Once again, I will recall it again. So water and minerals for the photosynthesis process get absorbed through the roots of a plant with the help of osmosis. Okay, and the absorbed water and minerals transported to the different parts of a plant with the help of the pipe-like structure, that is nothing but what? Xylem vessels, or it is also called as xylem tissues. Okay, so in this way they fulfill the requirements for the water and minerals. Now we move for the next one, that is nothing but what? Carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide are present in air, and as we know, the plants are using that carbon dioxide. But let's see how they are taking inside the carbon dioxide. So the carbon dioxide they are taking from the air. So on the lower portion of the leaf, there are the so many small tiny holes are present, and the tiny holes are called as what? Stomata. The tiny holes are called as stomata. Okay, that small holes which are present on the underside or the lower portion of the leaves, the tiny holes are called as stomata. And these stomatas are having the guard cell. Here you can see in the image, the stomatas having the guard cells, and that guard cells controls the movement of the stomata. Means with the help of that guard cell, the stomata gate opens and gate closed. Okay, means the guard cells helps of controlling the opening and the closing of the stomata. So with the help of the stomatas, the plants are taking inside carbon dioxide. Okay, so here up till now we have discussed about the two requirements, that is, that are water and minerals and carbon dioxide. Now next one we'll discuss about, that is nothing but what? Chlorophyll. Okay, so in our previous lecture also we had discussed that the chlorophyll is present in the chloroplast. Okay, so the chloroplast is the tiny bodies, okay, which are present in the cell, and in the tiny bodies the green color pigment is present, that is nothing but what? Chlorophyll. And this chlorophyll is helps to trap the solar energy, is help to absorb the sunlight, and with the help of that they are making the photosynthesis process. Okay, so this is the water and minerals, carbon dioxide and chlorophyll. Okay, so the leaves are green in color. Why? Because they contains the chlorophyll. Okay, but there are the certain plants, okay, in that instead of the leaf, the different part of a plant is making the, or is performing the photosynthesis. Which is that plant? Yes, you are correct. That is nothing but what? Cactus, which is very well known example for the desert plant. Okay, so the cactus is having the modification. Their leaves get modified into the spines, and their stem is the fleshy, thicky. Okay, and it is green in color because it contains the chlorophyll. And that is the reason in the cactus plant, instead of the leaves, the photosynthesis process is happens in the stem. Okay, so this is, here we have discussed about the chlorophyll. Now the next one important factor, or the next one important requirement which is necessary for the photosynthesis process, that is nothing but what? Sunlight. So the plants is absorb the sunlight with the help of the leaves. Why? Because the leaves are containing the chlorophyll, and with the help of the chlorophyll, the plants absorbs the maximum sunlight. And with the help of the photosynthesis process, what happens? The solar energy gets converted into the chemical energy. Okay, because they are using the solar energy, they are combining all these different materials, and they are performing their own food. Okay, so in this way, the solar energy gets converted into chemical energy in the process of photosynthesis. Okay, so on the part on the plant, the leaves are arranged in the form that they can get the maximum sunlight.
is O2. Okay, no need to always write the balanced equation. Okay, so this is the equation, or with the help of the equation also we can explain the photosynthesis process. Okay, so here we have discussed that plants are making their food, and the end product is called as what? Glucose. And the glucose is nothing but what? Simple sugar. Okay, and when once the food gets prepared, the food is necessary to distribute to the all the parts of the plant. So the food get transported to the different parts of the plant, but in that time what happens? The simple sugar, that is what? Glucose, is get converted into sucrose. Okay, means when the food prepared by the plant, it is in the which form? It is in the glucose form. But when it get transported to the different parts of a plant, it get converted into different type of the carbohydrate, and the name of that carbohydrate is nothing but what? Sucrose. And the sucrose is what? Complex carbohydrate. Okay, so in your previous standards, you have discussed that carbohydrates are having two types, that is starch and the sugar. Okay, so in this way the carbohydrates are also having the different types. Okay, this sucrose is nothing but the one type of carbohydrate, but it is which type of the carbohydrate? That is complex carbohydrate. So when the glucose is transported to the different parts of the plant, it get converted into the sucrose. So after that, the plants are making the food in a more amount, but all that food is doesn't get utilized. So extra food is get stored in the leaves of the plant in the form of starch, and this starch is nothing but again what? Complex carbohydrate. Okay, the starch is nothing but what? Complex carbohydrate. So it is very important term, student, keep in your mind that when the food get transported to the different parts of the plant, it transported in the form of what? Sucrose. And the extra food is get stored in the leaves of a plant in the form of what? Starch. That is also the one form of complex carbohydrate. Okay, so this is glucose, which is simple sugar, sucrose, that is complex carbohydrate, and starch is also what? Complex carbohydrate. Okay, so this is all about photosynthesis. Okay, so for photosynthesis, all these things are required, that are water and minerals, carbon dioxide, chlorophyll, and sunlight. Okay, but if you have seen that in our surrounding, in the nature, there are the so many ornamental plants are also there, or there are the so many different types of the plants. Some plants are having colorful leaves. It means they are not making the photosynthesis process. They doesn't contain the chlorophyll. Yes? No. The answer is what? No. The colorful leaves also contains the colorful leaves also contains the chlorophyll, but their chlorophyll get hide into the their different color pigment. Okay, so that the other color pigments are more, because of that what happens? The green color pigment gets hides inside the them, but that plants are also performing the photosynthesis process. Okay, so like that, so many colorful leaves are there, you can see in the images, that plants are also performing the photosynthesis process. They also contain the chlorophyll, but their chlorophyll get so hide under the color, another colorful pigments. Okay, so this is all about photosynthesis. For the photosynthesis, the plants requires water and minerals, carbon dioxide, chlorophyll, sunlight. Also they perform their food in the form of glucose, but when the glucose get transported to the different plant, it is get transported in the form of sucrose. Extra food gets stored in the form of starch, and water and minerals get absorbed by the root of the plants with the help of the osmosis. What is meant by osmosis? The movement of water molecules from the region of higher concentration to a semi-permeable membrane is called osmosis. Okay, so this is all about today. So today I'll end my